Hi all, welcome to our channel Microbiology Made Easy. So today I will discuss about an interesting topic, that is about the ox postulates. So last video was that is about the pioneers of microbiology. In that I didn't discuss about the ox postulates. So here I am discussing about the ox postulates. So what are ox postulates? So ox postulates are the important things, that is about which is pathogenic organism and which is non-pathogenic organism. So with following his rules, which is pathogenic and which is non-pathogenic will be identified. So here we are discussing about the Koch postulates. So Koch postulates are, the first thing is, from the suspected animal, from the suspected or diseased animal, suspected or diseased. So that is from the diseased animal we have to select the suspected pathogen. So organism should be isolated from the diseased animal. The next thing is, from the suspected pathogen we have to culture. So from the suspected pathogen, when we are inoculating into the pure culture, it should be grown. The next thing is, from the suspension from the pure culture, this suspension should be inoculated into the laboratory animal. When we are inoculating this suspension to the healthy animal, it should produce suspected pathogens. So it should be produced suspected pathogen. Again, the suspected pathogen, when we are inoculating into the culture media or pure culture, then it should produce colonies, or the suspected bacteria should be grown. So it should be identified with the microscopy. So when the suspected pathogen, suspected organism should be following these rules, that should be pathogenic organism. So next, non-pathogenic. How will you identify non-pathogenic? So it should not produce pathogen, cannot be grown in culture media. So this is about his Koch postulates. Thank you for listening to my presentation. Please do subscribe our channel Microbiology Made Easy. Thank you for listening my lecture. Thank you very much.